What do drones and robots have to do with Verizon's future in technology? Everything. In fact, now there's a new unit called Robotics Business Technology that is solving some of the most challenging problems that today's businesses face. To tell us more about it, here's Verizon Chief Strategy Officer Rima Qureshi and some friends at Mobile World Congress.
I want to introduce you to two of my friends. Gigi, affectionately named after our favorite technology, 5G, and Mekhail, after our other favorite, Mech. Sorry for the pun. Robots need to know where other robots are, but they also need to know what the environment looks like. Is there rough terrain ahead? Is there an obstacle in my way? Am I going to roll over someone's toe or run into a box? We're solving these problems right now.
We're really excited about the formation of this new group, Robotics Business Technology, because it really solidifies our mission and our vision in robotics that helps us to bridge this world of new, exciting frontier technology in hardware, software, and networking.
This technology is so exciting that we started to test the limits. To emulate real use cases, we started jumping in front of the robots to see how quickly they could recognize an obstacle and redirect. We threw boxes and sent other robots in their path. I'm happy to report that no Verizon engineers or robots were harmed in the testing, and the network performed beautifully. When the big hollow fire in Washington State threatened some of our critical communications infrastructure, the air quality was unsafe for humans. People living nearby were receiving orders to evacuate, and visibility was obviously very poor. Normally, the federal government would give permission for a drone to fly beyond visual line of sight only if there's an on-site pilot or observer. But our team had shown that our drones could fly without on-site personnel using our 4G LTE network. The government granted us a waiver, and we carried out the mission. The drone was able to send near real-time imagery to the operations leader in Alaska, 1,600 miles away.
What we're doing with Thin Client is we're taking that brain from the robot and moving it into the network. We are removing the requirement for these expensive and heavy sensors, and we're powering all of that decisioning intelligence by the network and by our software. What's the customer benefit of doing that? First, the actual machine itself is lighter, and when it is lighter, it has an extension opportunity for battery life. So we're extending the life of each battery operation for that mission, for that robot. It's a pretty big win. Secondarily, we are adding a hyper ability to provide all of that intelligence over the network with ultra low latency. The 5G network, with its blazing fast speeds and complementary assets with mobile edge compute, allow us to make those decisions. And that becomes really important when you have a falling box or you have a bird that flies in front of a drone. You need that decisioning to happen immediately. When I think about the 5G future, it represents a once in a lifetime opportunity to help shape the ways that customers and consumers and you and me and our families will live, work, and play differently.
We are advancing this field in the name of expanding human possibilities, not limiting them, in the name of augmenting the highest capacities of humanity, not replacing them. We understand that it's not just about drones or robots or maps or software. It's about the customers we serve and their vision of a better world. Thank you. Come on, guys.